Hi, my name's John Bryan, and I'm the author of Ghosts of Pocatello, Haunted History from the Gate City. I wrote this book as a compilation of ghostly stories that we have collected over the years doing paranormal research. Most of the stories come from the Haunted History Tour, which we put on every October as a fundraiser for our town here in Pocatello. But also there are a few stories that are first-hand accounts that were told to me by different people that I've met over the years. Some of the stories also come from members of our paranormal research group. Tonight, I'd like to share with you a story that was told to me by a man who was with us on our very first investigation. That night, he told me an incredible story that had happened to him of a ghostly experience that he had had inside of the building. The story had such an impression on me that I put it as the first story in my book. So let's begin Ghosts of Pocatello with the first chapter. Chapter 1, The Ghost of Pocatello High School. Pocatello High School loomed in front of Grant as his car turned the corner in the overcast moonlight. Grant smiled as he came face to face with the prodigious school. It never failed to amaze him as he gazed at the beautiful architecture of the 100-year-old school. He marveled at how well it had withstood the test of time. The original school was built in 1892 and became the town square in the developing city of Pocatello. The community used the building for community plays, sports, and Sunday picnics. The building was also an important gathering point for the region, even attracting two United States presidents to campaign at the school. In 1914, a fire in the boiler room caused a massive inferno, devastating the structure, burning it to the ground. It took 3 years to rebuild the school on the same spot as the original. Pocatello High School was reopened in 1917 and continues to stand as the centerpiece of Old Town Pocatello. Grant was in a hurry because it was Thanksgiving morning. He had not finished his work from the night before due to a family event. His wife had gotten up with him to start preparing the delicious meal that would be waiting for him when he finished his work. It had been raining all night, and Grant could still hear the rain falling outside. He walked along the halls of the massive high school where he had been the janitor for over 20 years. It was quiet in the hallways, and Grant enjoyed the time to himself. Over the years, he had become accustomed to being alone in the century-old building. During his time at the school, Grant had heard of strange happenings where people were alone by themselves in the building. Many of the other janitors were apprehensive about being alone in the school. Some of Grant's co-workers believed the school was haunted, but he did not believe in ghosts. One janitor told a story of being alone in a downstairs bathroom where all of the toilets began to flush at the same time. Another faculty member was called to the school when the elevator went crazy and began to go up and down all by itself. A repairman was called but never found the problem. Finally, there was a story of a young librarian who had hung herself on a chandelier. The urban legend said the librarian was in love but was left at the altar. She was so distraught she committed suicide in the library. For over 30 years, people have seen the apparition of a lonely librarian standing in the library window. Grant never let ghost stories bother him when he was at work. As he walked the hallways of the three-story building, he thought of all the delicious food waiting for him at home. Turkey, pumpkin pie, cranberries, olives, salads, ham, mashed potatoes, and gravy, followed by football after the evening feast. Oh, how Grant loved Thanksgiving. He rushed to the empty garbage cans in the classrooms throughout the school. He knew he was close to being done and could return home to spend the rest of his holiday with his family. Grant finished emptying the trash and took the bags out to the dumpster. He was disappointed to find the rain falling even harder than when he had arrived. After finishing all his other responsibilities, Grant began his final task of the morning. He purposefully left this job until last. Even though he had worked in Pocatello High School for more than 2 decades, he still felt anxious in the trophy room. The trophy room was the oldest part of the school. It was located in the middle of the building just off the main hallway, across from the principal's office. Many called it the heart of Pokey High because of its location and the feeling of stepping back in time. The awards of the past century filled the cases and acted as a reminder of the generations that had passed through the school. It was not the room itself that made Grant feel uneasy. It was the stairway located on the other side of the room. The stairway led down an unused gymnasium. which had been a swimming pool many years before. In the first part of the 20th century, the pool had been used for swim meets until a tragedy occurred. It was believed that a student had drowned in the pool, and the school had changed it into a gymnasium. Generations of Pocatello High School students believed the gymnasium and trophy room were haunted by the spirit of the student who had died. Grant began to mop the floor. He knew he was close to being able to return home to his family. He focused on his job, working quickly but with attention to detail. With each pass of the mop, the task came closer to the end. Soon he was at the back of the room, nearly done and nearly free. Grant dipped his mop one last time. As he pushed the mop across the floor, Grant began to sense that he was not alone. He raised his head slowly and looked around the room. Everything was quiet, and then he saw him. A boy was standing in the doorway from the main hall. Grant was startled for a moment, but then noticed the boy was dripping wet. He looked like any other boy, wearing jeans, sneakers, and a red cotton jacket. The boy looked cold, scared, and disoriented. Grant could feel the atmosphere change. The melancholy figure seemed to drain away any light from the room. Grant was baffled as to why the boy was there or how he had gotten into the school. "What are you doing here?" Grant asked. The boy responded, "I came in out of the rain." "Well, how did you get in?" "The doors are locked," Grant replied. The boy flashed a shy, embarrassed glance and then looked away, hiding his face from Grant. "No, I just came in out of the rain." The boy forced the sound from his lips as if it was causing him great pain. "Well, I'm sorry, son, but you can't be in here." "I will walk you to the door," Grant said as he turned to put the mop back into the bucket. Grant looked away from the boy for only a second, but when he turned to walk him out, the boy was gone. He was not startled because he thought the boy had quickly started down the hall headed for the door. As Grant entered the main hall, he suddenly realized there was no one there. The hallway was too long for the boy to have made it to the door. Even if he had run, there were no doors he could have ducked into. Grant ran to the end of the hall where it was crossed by another hallway that spanned the width of the south end of the building. It was empty. The high school was large and had many entrances from the outside. The problem was the alarm system. It would have sounded if any of the entrances were disturbed. Grant had rearmed it when he came in. Still, he checked every door, but they were all locked and the alarm was set. With each passing moment, the uneasy feeling in his stomach began to grow. Grant knew what he had seen, but he could not accept what it meant. He began to rationalize how the boy could have left the building without setting off the alarms. All of the doors in the school were locked except for the bathrooms. Yes, the bathrooms did not have doors, and the boy could be hiding in a stall. Systematically, Grant searched the bathrooms one by one. He checked them all, both male and female, until he came up empty. What had he seen? Who was the boy? Why had he seemed so sad? All of these questions raced through his head. Suddenly, it was too much, and Grant ran to the exit. He ran through the doors as fast as he could and didn't even take time to put away his mop. He jumped in his car and drove home in the pouring rain. Grant returned to the school and continued working there for many years. He never saw the boy again, but always remembered the melancholy figure he met in the trophy room at Pocatello High School.